If you're confused about Google Kids credit score incentive percentage system, then trust me, you are not alone. It was for me an absolute beast to try to figure out, but thankfully I've gone and done all the work so that I can bring to you the most simple and easy way to understand what Google Kids credit score means and how to calculate your own incentives. Welcome, welcome all to my channel. My name is Jenna Lee from LiveEatTeach.com. And in my channel, I talk all about teaching tips and tricks as an online teacher, building your own online teaching business, and becoming your own boss. Many of my videos are made to help my referrals get hired in as easy and fast of a way as possible. And if you're not already one of my referrals, you can have me as a hiring coach if you use my link below and you email me. And I love to help teachers get hired onto my companies because it was a life changer for me, and I want to help others have the flexibility and freedom to teach online as well. That being said, let's get into what your Google Kid credit score incentive is. What I'm going to say next is so important to remember, and it is that no matter what your Google Kid credit score or level is, it will not change your base rate. And your base rate is what you got when you first got hired onto Google Kid. For example, my base rate is $8.80, and a lot of other teachers fall into the range between $8 and $10 of your base rate pay, which is that pay that you get per 25-minute class. So now that we know that our base rate is stable and it will not change, I want you to take out a piece of paper and something to write with. All of Google Kids incentives are based around this formula that I'm telling you to write down or keep a mental note of in your head. And it is your incentive base multiplied by your incentive percentage equals your credit score incentive. If you are like this right now and this just went over your head, that is okay. I'm going to explain what these terms mean. So the first term in this formula is your incentive base. And I like to nickname this your daily reward because this is calculated daily. And it is based off of how many classes you teach in that specific day. It's actually based off of this chart that I'm going to show you right here. So as you can see in this chart, if you teach 2 to 3 classes today, then your incentive base is 1.5. And if you teach 9 or more classes today, your incentive base is going to be 2. If you know your incentive base right now and how many classes you've taught today, then jot this down in that formula above. The second term in this formula is called incentive percentage, and my nickname for this is your teaching performance level. It's based off of 5 levels, as you can see in this chart over here. And each of these levels is related to how well you perform as a teacher in class and also outside of class. So these things are all related to your parent feedback, your teaching performance in class, if you attended class on time and didn't leave early, if you had no cancellations, and if you had no teacher IT issues. So as you can see in this chart, levels 1 and 2, they have 0%. So that actually means that you would get no incentive on top of your base rate if you were at a credit level of 1 or 2. So as you can see in this chart, your incentives will start on level 3 at 100%, and then level 4 is 110%, and level 5 is 125%. If you don't know where to find which level you're on, it's actually really easy. And if you have the Google Kid app, then you can open this, or you can go into your teacher's portal, and it should come right up on the left-hand side of the home page. So as you can see, when I click on this, you can see your levels at the very top. At this point, I hope you understand a little bit more about what these two terms mean in the formula, but now I want you to help you understand how this formula is actually used to calculate your incentive. So I'm gonna go through 3 different examples to help you have a very clear picture of how to calculate these formulas. Okay, so let's say teacher Annie has taught 4 classes today, which if you look in the incentive base chart, that means that her incentive base is 1.7. And she is currently at a level 4. So she has 110% incentive percentage. So if we multiply those two together, 1.7 times 110%, that is going to come to 1.87 credit score incentive. So what you're going to do is you're going to add that onto her base rate. So let's say her base rate is $8. So if you're going to add $8 and 1.87, then that is going to equal $9.87 per 25-minute class. Our next example is teacher Max. And teacher Max has taught 8 classes today. So his incentive base is at 1.8. And he has a level 3. So he has 100% incentive percentage. So let's multiply those together again, and that is going to come to 1.8. So you're going to add that onto his base rate pay. And let's say his base rate pay is $8.50. So all in all, let's do the math here. $8.50 plus $1.80 equals $9.30 per 25-minute class. Let's do one more example just to get a clear picture of this formula. So now we have teacher Tia, and she has taught 9 classes. Wow, 9 classes today. So her incentive base is 2. It is the highest incentive base. However, she is right now on a level 2. So her incentive percentage is at 0%, and anything multiplied by 0 is 0. So she unfortunately does not get any more incentive on top of her base rate. Now I know that Google Kids credit score can be so overwhelming, and if you have any more questions or concerns about this, please comment below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. To help get you prepared, I have put the links to these charts below so that you can just go right ahead and use these charts to calculate your own incentive. I hope this helped, and I'll see you next time.